Hey, welcome back to Build Sim. In this video I want to show you how to mark out or set out a stringer for a set of stairs. So obviously I'm going to put a set of stairs off this ramp down onto the ground like such. Just remember, when you guys do it, you'll actually have to have somewhere for it to land, making sure it doesn't sit hard on the ground so that you allow for termites and you don't get water pooling around it. So yeah, just make sure you guys make those allowances. But I've got a rise of flight of 700 mil and a going of flight of 1.50 meters, and I can work out roughly using Pythagoras that my staircase is roughly going to be 1260 mil long. Give myself a little bit of play on both ends and round up for the next timber size. So I'm going to end up with a piece of timber about 1800 long to start my job or start the process. In this case it's 240 mil wide, which I would think would be sort of a minimum for a stair stringer. Okay, so now we need to actually set out our staircase. Now I always tend to go with a 50 mil margin. Again, 50 mil is just a figure I've plucked. So you can use any figure you like. It could be 30. And in some cases, I've seen stairs with no margin, and I've actually seen them with a negative margin, where the treads actually stick past the edge of the stair. So really up to you how you do that. Okay, now you would do some lead-up calculations, which I'm going to put in another video, to work out what the rise of your stair is and what the going of your stair is. And you need to set up your steel square to show that. So I would put the rise of my square from my margin line, okay, down on my tongue, and the going of my stair on my blade to my margin line. And then I would set up my buttons or my fence to set that dimension. So remember, from the margin line, not from the edge of our stringer. And always start, probably 100 mil or so in from the end of your piece of timber. And then all you need to do is draw in your rise and your going. And you can then step that out down your stringer with however many rises and goings that you need for your staircase. Okay, so in this case I've only need three treads. Okay, this is actually going to be the ground line, and this will be where it butts up to the deck. So next, you can draw in where your actual treads are going to go. There's a couple of different ways of doing this. You can just trace it in. You can cut the entire trench out so it comes all the way out the back. And if you're going to do it that way, you can use a power saw and a chisel to chisel that out. Or obviously you can use a router. You could decide just to chisel out for the actual tread itself. And again, this is you can do this one with a router, or you can also just use brackets, so no trenching required. Screw the bracket to your stringer, obviously allowing for the thickness of the tread down from your line. So whichever method you're going to go with, that's up to you, but you need to cut them out. So the next thing I'm going to look at is finishing off the ends of the stringer. So down here, this, as I said, this dimension here is our ground line. We actually need to extend that through back this way, because we're actually going to cut that end all the way off. And what I tend to do is, whatever my margin line is, I come off my first rise line the same distance. So my margin was 50 mil, so I'm going to come out here 50 mil and put a line in there. So I'm actually going to cut all this end off. On the other end, I'm going to extend my last riser line all the way through. So I'm actually going to cut that off as well. However, I want to leave a little hook or a horn or a haunch, depending on where you're from, on the end to hook over my deck or my landing. So what I do is, where this line intersects with the margin line, I'm going to come off here at 90 degrees. Where it intersects with the edge of my stringer, I'm going to come off here at 90 degrees, like such. And then where this line hits my margin line again, I'm going to come back down to form my haunch or my horn. So I would actually end up cutting this whole end off again to sit over our step. So our stringer is going to end up looking something like that, and that should sit up there nicely into the right spot. Again, making sure you allow for your termite and water protection down this end. So there you go. There's the process of setting out a set or a stringer for a stair. Remember, you now have to repeat that in mirror for the other side.